becoming more isolated from China as a way to weaken China, I think the most serious concern is that what will happen is that the United States will only isolate itself. And that's completely the case when we think about higher education, which is already globalized. So if the United States becomes more shut down to international students, this will harm the United States, and it will really not hurt China. It will probably benefit other universities in places like England and Australia and Canada, where these students who have been preparing to go to the United States, they'll look at what the United States looks at now. It looks very closed, looks potentially hostile to Chinese students. They'll just go to another country. So I don't think framing the problem of geopolitical competition with China as a excuse to make us more closed will only shoot ourselves in the foot.
I just wanted to add, there's a broader line of thinking around this issue, which is effectively academic decoupling. We need to stop training so many Chinese citizens, especially in our PhD programs in STEM. That's a lot of the legislation that came out in the last 2 years of the Trump administration generally had that sentiment behind it. And I think one of the key issues here, as people think about it, the problem of intellectual theft, is that we tend to focus on the bad actors, the bad behavior that is worrisome, and then forget the overwhelming benefits that the U.S. gets from this type of relationship. There are over 100,000 Chinese citizens at the graduate level and beyond studying STEM at U.S. universities in a given year. We've only had a handful of cases, which means that for all intents and purposes, for every one bad actor, there are thousands, if not tens of thousands, of Chinese citizens that are here contributing to the U.S. research enterprise, and most importantly, that want to stay. According to data from the NSF, 90% of Chinese PhD students want to come and assimilate and become U.S. citizens. So this is a tremendous win for the United States. And to shut off that relationship would, again, accelerate the rise of institutions outside the United States, accelerate the rise of Chinese institutions. So I think there's so much focus on the cases of theft or espionage and so forth, and not enough coverage of all the contributions that Chinese citizens and Chinese Americans are making.